Perfect. question for you, is it off the plan? Would it be better? Would it be better if it were the TV from there? Because for me to walk back and forth and can't really reach. He wants to look at this one, so maybe we can bring this TV over here closer ahead. So Susa, and Shemaine is the same choice. And so Nehemiah is there, and he is the cupbearer, and he works in the king, and so he travels all the way here to Israel. Why does he do that?
Whoa.
Why do you travel? The walls were destroyed and the gates were burned and there was no protection for the city, so he traveled to Jerusalem to rebuild the wall. So Nehemiah, remember he was mocked by all these people and there's a guy from here and a guy from here, a guy from all these areas, surrounding areas, who became enemies of Nineveh, and we'll see even more of that today, the more problems. And Nehemiah is here trying to build the walls, and we keep seeing the problems occur, and then first moves from the outside, and the enemies, and then the people on the inside are panicking, and then they have a plan where they just have their swords and work. And then last week, we saw another problem amongst the people.
Oh, no!
We saw there was a problem with money, finances, because the Jewish people on the inside were charging other Jews interest than saying that you owe us more money for this, and so the Jews who were poor were again saying that they were barely making it, they needed help. And Jews from Nehemiah heard all this and he was mad. So what he did was he brought in all the people, the rulers and the rich, and said, "Hey, you guys are wrong. You shouldn't be doing this. You shouldn't be forcing all these dues." And we need to fear the Lord. Remember, his emphasis was on fearing God and not being so selfish and taking advantage of money and being so focused on finances, but to focus on the Lord instead. And so Nehemiah is saying this. And so that's what we saw last week. Nehemiah mentions that he has now become the governor, and he could have been, charging people money to pay him, but he said, "I don't do that. I'm working and earning my own money. I'm not getting paid from as a governor." So far, these are the tools problems here, it's coming, Nehemiah saying, this is the issue, this is the problem, and he was trying to make sure that everyone is still focused on working and not quitting, that they would continue the work. And we saw that in the last several weeks, and today we're going to see another problem. Sure, Nehemiah was just so annoyed and frustrated by people coming to him saying that here's another problem. Let's see what today is. Nehemiah 6:1. Nehemiah is focused on the work of the walls, and they're all working, and the walls are up. They're almost finished. Sanballat has friends up here on the north in the Samaria. And so here, all around here, are all coming against Nineveh, or Nehemiah. So they're surrounded by people who don't like them, enemies. They're all annoyed by what's going on. Right here. so he says, well, let's meet here. What is that called? How many of you like college football? Sometimes, if one team and another team are very good teams, and they go to one home state, but instead of going to each other's home stadium, they go to a neutral side, a neutral stadium. And every year, there is one in Jacksonville, Florida. They have that, and that is whenever Georgia plays against the Florida Gators in Jacksonville, Florida. They always play in that stadium because if the Florida people go to Georgia or Georgia goes to Florida, there's going to be a big old fight. So they meet somewhere else that's more of the neutral side. So you can say that's happening here where all these surrounding places are their Jerusalem's enemies. So they're saying, hey, Nehemiah, meet us here. So what did he do? I sent messengers unto them saying, sorry, I'm busy right now. I'm doing a great work so that I cannot come down. Mm-hmm. Why should the work cease? Why should it stop? Because if I leave and come down to you, it will stop. So he goes, sorry, no, I'm not coming. I'm busy. You know, sometimes we as Christians, we work when we're working and serving the Lord, and someone says, hey, I need help. I need to do this, and I need this, and this, and that. And we're in the middle of doing something for the Lord, and someone says, do this, and you feel like you're caught in the middle, and you don't know what to do, and so you say, okay, I'll come do this instead. And maybe if I help them, oh, they'll come to church or they'll come help me. But there's already people here where I'm at. There's already servants here. And there's already, we're all working together. Why would I leave all of us, everyone working together, to go help this one person? I just need to say no. Sorry, thank you. Nehemiah, who called Nehemiah to go work, God did. God called Nehemiah to work. Remember, what was Nehemiah doing? What did he do at home? Whenever he heard the news of Jerusalem, what he knew, he responded with weeping and mourning. Prayed for 4 months. He was determined. God has called me to go do this work, and I'm going to go work. God has called me to work, and now I have these people trying to take me away. Well, hold on, God. I'm going to walk away from your work and go see what these guys want. And if Nehemiah did that, he probably... Who gave Nehemiah permission to go? That Sanballat and Geshem, they're nobody. They're not important. They're just little governors. You know, the king knows me, and the king knows my name, and I'm tight with the king, and you're over here trying to give me a hard time. You know, I know the king. You know, people will say that, well, you better watch out. Pastor wants the law, and America is changing, and you can't preach against these certain things, and you can't preach against sin, or homosexuality, or you can't speak out against these things. You know what? I'm sorry, I know the king. I'm not worried about people. I have a great work right now, and I'm not going to stop. And that's how Nineveh is. These guys, they're not going to bother me. I know the king. And I know who called me here. Why would I stop doing the work here where I'm at? I'm sorry, I'm not going to stop. I'm going to keep working. Do you think that Sanballat and Geshem and those guys said, oh, okay, he said no, well, it's a movie. Verse 4, so they sent unto me 4 times. So I can imagine Nehemiah working hard at work, and he's working on the wall, and he's doing what he needs to do, and he gets a letter. Oh, here's the mail, and he gets it out, and he starts reading it, and so he calls his messengers and says, hey, go tell them that, no, I'm busy. I can't go right now. I'm working. So he gets back to work, and he's doing his thing, and then the next day, he gets another piece of mail, and he's like, oh, again. So he sends his messengers and tells them, hey, tell them I said no, I'm not coming. And so then a third time, the next day, he gets a message, and they're asking him to meet him out in Ono, and so he tells the messenger, tell him, no, I'm not going. And then a fourth time, what? 4 times? They kept bothering him. 4 times they kept asking him. He said, oh, okay, fine. Well, they're hoping that he'll just go now, just to make them shut up. And so he was trying to give in, but Nehemiah did not. They were hoping that Nehemiah would give in and go and meet them. But Nehemiah kept his word. He said, no, I'm not going. My kids would do that. Dad, hey, can I just have this? I'll say no. And those smarts, they would, mom, hey, can I do this? yourself, and that's what you want, and you're still going to see people out preaching, and I've heard it. I've heard this is the rumor going around, and I know what's going on. Is that true? No. They're just making this up. They're just, well, who gave Nehemiah permission? The king sent him over there, along with the king's soldiers. Don't forget, Nehemiah had the king's soldiers with him, sent from the king. Well, maybe the king's soldiers are hearing this, and they start, oh, is this true? And they start questioning, and, oh, we're in trouble if that's true. Nehemiah simply answered fake news. Yeah, he does. Then I sent unto them saying, there are no such things done as thou sayest, but thou feignest them out of thy own heart. He made me up. This is fake news. You have to come out here and we got to talk about this, or we're going to tell a king what you're doing. And Nehemiah's like, all right, I'm going to keep working. He didn't become nervous or scared or worried about what they're going to go do. And he's like, well, I'm going to keep working and stay busy here. There was no worry or stress in his response. Why? Because I know God, and I fear the Lord, and I'm following God, and I have the king's approval. Why should I worry about these guys? That's the same. This applies to you and I. Why should we fear? Why should we worry? We know who God is, and God has called us to do these things, so why should we worry about what other people think, or how other people perceive us or judge us? Oh, well, you could have all these things. Well, I'm going to follow God. And that's that. I'm not going to stop what I'm doing here. I have a great work. I have a big job to do. And I'm going to do this for God. And I'm not going to stop for you. No way. I'm going to stop. So the enemy Nehemiah's response, and more rumors are spread, which causes fear to seek. For they all made us afraid, saying, their hands shall be weakened from the work that be not done. They're not going to finish the work. So Nehemiah is working, he says no, he keeps getting bothered 3, 4, 5 times. And Nehemiah says, no, I'm not, I'm working. And Nehemiah is still strong. But the people around him, no. Solve it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. They started fear. Nehemiah was not fearful, but everyone around him was starting to get afraid and questioning and suspecting and worrying. And so what does Nehemiah do? He's God giving strength. These people, their hands are they're becoming weak to do the work. I need you. Do you think they stopped the enemy and left him alone? No, they did it at least 5 times. And the 5th time, they threatened him. And now they are going to try to get inside and try to find someone on the inside. Maybe send a spy. And so they worked up this plan. So after Nehemiah came into the house of Shemaiah, the son of Deliah, the son of Mehetabel, who was shut up with me inside, and said, "Why? Let us meet together in the house of God in the temple. And let us shut the doors of the temple, for when they come, they are probably going to come to kill you. And the night, they come to kill you. So we better go inside the temple and hide out in the temple." Shemaiah is a Jew. Shut up. What does that mean? It probably means old. like wheelchair, or he back then probably couldn't walk, or maybe it could mean wise. Worked as a priest or a Levite. We don't know this means as far as describing it, but Nehemiah respected him, it seems like here. And also it seems like he also had access to the temple. So he says, "Come on, come here, Nehemiah. It's been tough. You've had it tough. These guys have been coming to you 5 times now. We better go out to the temple. Let's go in the temple. It's safe there." I think that's a pretty good idea, right? It's really simple. Why not? One problem. In your eyes, Nehemiah a priest?
No.
Is Nehemiah a priest? Yes or no? Is Nehemiah a Levite? He's not supposed to go into the temple. Only for a special gathering can all go into the temple. But other than that, only the priest, if only the Levite, a Levite is allowed into the temple. So if Nehemiah were to go into the temple, he'd be breaking God's law. It sounds like a good idea. Let's go into the temple. Let's hide out in the temple. In my mind, I kind of envision this like in a movie. Nehemiah is sitting down talking to this wise old man and saying, "Hey, what should I do? Give me some advice." And he's like, "Hey, come. You should go to the temple. Go to the temple and let's stay safe there." And so Nehemiah looks at him and is like all of a sudden suspicious of, "Are you a spy? Why would you ask me to go into the temple?" So Nehemiah said, "Should such a man as I flee and go into hiding?" So I should go to the temple to save my life? I will not go in. I don't do that. Nehemiah says, "You think I'm scared? You think that I need to go hide? You think I need to run? No, I refuse to do that. If they want me, they can come and get me. I'm not going to go hide and be fearful and God's house and the and that they might have matter for a good report, that they might reproach me and spread the news, and I would lose my authority. Nehemiah prays, and he says, my God, think thou upon Tobiah and Sanballat, according to these their works. This is very interesting here. The prophetess, Noadiah, who is this woman? We don't know. There's no other verse in the Bible talks about, that mentions this woman, just this one verse here. There is another verse that has a similar name, but it's talking about a man. But this, we don't know, it is Jewish name. Who is this woman? And Nehemiah says, remember her, remember God that you took care of her, or remember her and take care of her, and all these other prophets. Her and the other prophets that have put him to fear. God, remember these people who are trying to make him fearful. But Nehemiah stood firm and he said, I will not fear. 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 That's the message that you and I need today. Look at America. It's a mess. Politics. Look at Israel. Impeachment. All that. Why should I fear? These are just men here on earth. Can men defeat God? It's impossible. These guys were all over Nehemiah against. I will not fear in the mind of God. Nehemiah refused to lose his focus. He refused to be distracted. He refused to be bothered by rumors. You know, I've experienced this. Does it bother me? Oh, yeah, sure, it bothers me. Could it cause me to stop the work if I allowed it to? Nehemiah refused to let that stop him. People were all talking around about him, trying to report it to the king, and he kept going. Did he compromise? No. He refused to compromise. Well, why? What tool did Nehemiah use? One of the best we're going to see. And this tool right now in Christianity as a whole lacks this tool. The tool of faith. fact that will allow the rumors to talk against me to pull me away from the work? Will I compromise? Or will I stand firm, stand faithful? Faithful. Which is it for you? I'm happy that Nehemiah had his big toolbox. And he opened it up. Oh, well, hold on, he looks for this. David, do that. He's very organized with his tools, but I'm not. I'm a mess. So I'm looking for the tools now. Where is that tool that I had? And Nehemiah had it all ready. He picked up that tool and he used it. That faithfulness. He did not stop. He did not give up. He did not quit. He persisted. He remained faithful. Maybe you're here today and you're saying, you know, I've lost my focus. I am distracted. And I have other things on my mind, other things that I need to take care of. I need to focus. Focus on God first, and all those things will be completed. Nehemiah said, oh, hold on, God, I gotta put this word on hold, and let me go fix this problem with these guys, and let me go work it out with them. And well, he would have been dead. Killed. Instead, he stayed focused on God. He said, I'm not stopping, I'm not quitting, I'm not giving up. I'm going to stay right here, and I am going to work. I've got work to do. Focused on you and what you are calling me to do with that high, that I place that as a high priority. And if something comes up, I put it on hold and put you first. And if that hold becomes a lost opportunity or